Well, I went and did it again. I spent way too much time on an app to add a feature to a program that really should just be in there natively. In this case, Plex. It's a software that lets you stream files and videos to other devices. And the feature that I wanted to add takes care of a situation I think many of us have been in. You're watching a TV show or a movie, and you can't hear a particular single line that one of the actors says. So what do you have to do? Well, you can rewind it and try to listen again, or eventually you just give up and try to turn on the subtitles, which involves rewinding and then pausing, and then opening the settings and enabling the subtitles, then closing the settings, playing it back, seeing what they said, then pausing it, doing the same thing over in the settings, and resuming. However, this should not happen in 2025. The technology is there to fix this. Like the Apple TV Plus app specifically has a feature where if you rewind, you hit the rewind button, it turns on subtitles temporarily for those 10 seconds, because 99% of the time you hit that rewind button, it probably is to hear what they just said. And then when it reaches the original point, it turns them off again. And so that is exactly what my app does. It interacts with the Plex API to basically monitor when you're watching a show and where you are in the timeline, and it detects if you hit the rewind button, and if you do, it sends a signal to the player to turn on the subtitles and then remembers where you were originally, and when you reach that point again, it turns them back off. Plus, it has some extra handling of other special cases that I'll go over in a second. The app, which is open source, you can get it on GitHub, I'll put the link in the description, is just a console app. It is cross-platform, I made it that way, so it'll run on Windows, macOS, even Linux. So if you have your Plex server on a NAS or something that runs off Linux or ARM, you can still run on that. And it should work on any of the official Plex player apps like iOS, Apple TV, Android. Though I will point out, you're gonna have to do one thing, which is go into each of the app settings, and there's gonna be one called Advertise as Remote Player, and you have to enable that, otherwise the player will not respond to commands. So that's just one thing to remember. Now, there is some additional features and logic that I put in. For example, if you manually enable subtitles, like it sees the subtitles turn on and it didn't do that, it will not mess with those. So if you manually turn on subtitles, they'll stay on until you turn them off again. It also will detect if you rewind multiple times. So if you rewind more than just the initial 10 seconds, you go back 20 or 30 seconds, it will still enable the subtitles and continue playing them until you reach the original point. There is a maximum setting, though, where if you rewind past that, it'll disable them again. And that is in the settings option. There's a whole settings config file. Also, it will cancel the subtitles if you fast forward while it's being temporarily displayed. So if you fast forward back, it probably means you don't need them anymore. And there's a settings file that has a whole bunch of other settings. Some of them you probably don't want to touch, but they're just kind of there. For the most part, you could just leave these as the default. Really, the only one you might want to change is the server URL and port to, obviously, if it's not on your same computer you're running it on, you can put it there. Another one some people might want to look at is the subtitle preference pattern setting. This lets you basically control, based on the name of the subtitle, which ones it will try to look at first to use. So if you put English, it'll use ones that have that first. Now, as for how to install and set up the program, you don't actually have to install it. It's just one file. When you run it the first time, it will create the settings file and it'll ask you to authorize the app with your Plex account, and then it'll get a token and create a token file, and you won't have to do that again. And also, you'll notice that it shows up in your devices list in your Plex account. And then you can just run it and it's kind of set it and forget it. Since this app is one that is meant to be just run in the background and sits idle most of the time, you can run it in background mode and it won't even open the console window. You can do that with the dash background launch parameter. So you could, for example, create a shortcut to it that has that parameter and then put it in the Windows startup directory, and then it'll just start with Windows. And it will stay idle in the background as long as there's no actual apps playing any videos or anything. It tells the Plex server to basically subscribe to events. So it's not like it's going to keep polling in the background. It waits to come out of idle mode from the Plex server telling it to. If you do want to stop the app without having to go into the task manager and killing it, there's also a dash stop parameter, which you just launch the same exe and use that parameter, and it will tell any other instances running to stop, and that'll work. Now, I will point out one quirk that I noticed with Plex Player apps that might manifest themselves, especially if you're trying to test out this app where you're gonna start playing a video and then immediately press rewind and see if it turns on the subtitles. It turns out that the players, at least the iOS and Apple TV ones, if you try to rewind back into video that didn't buffer, so you start playing a video in the middle of it and then immediately hit rewind after you start it, the Plex player will say that it enabled the subtitles and it'll even show in the menu, but it won't show them. That only seems to be a problem with embedded subtitles, I found. So if you're gonna test out the app, watch for about 10 seconds and then rewind and it should work. Though I will point out that problem only seems to occur if it's embedded subtitles, like in the video. If you use external subtitles, like it's a separate file, that doesn't seem to be a problem at all. Now, there is one planned feature, I haven't added this yet, but I'm probably going to soon, and that is a way to manually enable and disable the subtitles by like double-clicking or triple-clicking the play button or something else, so that if you want to only manually enable and disable the subtitles, then you can avoid at least having to go through the whole menu and turning it on. So anyway, I'd be curious to know what you guys think. Hopefully a lot of you will enjoy this as much as I did. I basically just did it because I was annoyed myself, and I really do hope they add the feature natively, because it'll probably work a lot better than having to have a thing running, and sometimes it's not perfect. So still, Plex, if you're watching, please add this feature. I think everybody would love it. So let me know how it works down in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, as usual, give it a big giant thumbs up. I appreciate it. And if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I made another app for Logitech keyboards that had a stupid problem that I fixed. So I'll put that link right there and click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.